Dear students, I welcome you in the lecture series of Systems Mechanical Engineering. Basically, it is basics about mechanical engineering. And we are looking at some of the power plants of mechanical engineering. Today, we will be looking at thermal power plant. So, let's see. Basically, one must understand the principle of the geothermal power plant. Geo means earth. And thermal means heat. So thermal energy which can be obtained from earth crust and that is utilized for electricity generation. It is known from many years that core of the earth is considerably hot and it has also been found that earth contains a large reservoir of steam. This naturally available steam can be directed for the steam power plant. Basically, there are different methods by which this geothermal power plant can be run. And that is based on available energy sources and its temperature. So, first one is a dry steam power plant where available energy is more than 250 degrees Celsius or 35 degrees Celsius. Then flash steam power plant where available energy, geothermal energy will be up to 350 degrees Celsius. And third one is binary cycle power plant where available energy may be up to 100 degrees Celsius or quite more than that. So today we will be discussing about binary cycle power plants. So this is a schematic representation of binary cycle geothermal power plant. This is a ground level. So, from the earth surface, almost from 300 meters to several kilometers, there will be some heat source. Basically, it will be a steam or the brine, salty liquid, which will be having some temperature. And that heat can be utilized for our application. So, in the earth crust or on the surface, some drills are made. So, one will be called as a production well and another drill may be called as a rejection well. So, from production well, the source of heat can be obtained. As we are discussing about binary cycle, from production well, the brine solution will be obtained, which will be having very high temperature. Up to 100 degrees Celsius or up to 200 degrees Celsius. So that brine solution means salt solution, it is taken to heat exchanger where it is exchanging heat to the some of the organic liquids. For example, the isobutane, pentane or the freon. So when those organic liquids are heated, those will be easily converted into steam. So here those organic materials converted into steam, those are passed to the turbine. As a result, steam will be expanded and turbine will be rotating. The rotation of the turbine shafts are connected to generator and then electricity can be produced. Now this low pressure steam is collected to the condenser. In the condenser, this steam is condensed and converted into liquid. So again that low pressure organic liquid is pumped back to the heat exchanger with the help of condensate extraction pump. Now in the condenser what is happening, the cool water from the base of the cooling tower, it is circulated with the help of recirculating pump and it is going inside the condenser coil. So where the water is cooling the steam but it is getting heated. And then that hot water is made fall from the top of the cooling tower. As this hot water droplets are falling down with the gravity, those are getting cooled and at the base those are getting settled. So at the base you are getting cool water which will be pumped back and this is a cyclic process. What we have seen in this cycle, the low boiling point temperature organic fuels are heated, converted to steam and circulated here. So this is called as a binary fuel. On other case, the brine solution, after exchanging its heat from the heat exchanger, it is sent back to the rejection wall. So where it is going to the earth crust or that level of the heat energy. So this process is continuous. I hope it is clear to you. Then earlier we have seen there are basically two more types. One is dry steam and another is flash steam. Dry steam means from the production well you are getting very hot steam where it may be more than 300 degrees Celsius. And then that direct steam is passed over the turbine and turbine is running. It is rotated. And then it is condensed and then it will be directly sent to the rejection well. So as direct dry steam we are using for turbine rotations and electricity generation, it is called dry steam power plant. Where in case of flash steam power plant, the brine solution or a wet steam, which will be hot of course, it is collected in some flash chamber. Like a heat exchanger, there will be a flash chamber where there is a water in another tank and water is heated and converted into steam. The steam is blown over the turbine and electricity can be produced. But after heating the water, excess amount of wet steam, it will be rejected to the rejection well. So that's why that is called as a flash steam geothermal power plant. Next, we'll see the advantages of binary cycle geothermal power plant. First is it is reliable source. Then it has no harmful emissions. It has a very high efficiency. It has a very low maintenance. Then no external source required to keep plant running condition. Power stations are smaller and those are at specific locations only, and that is becoming one of the disadvantages actually. Then few disadvantages. There is a possibility of depletion of geothermal resources because those are changing their locations, and then once those are used, maybe we'll not have that again. High initial or investment cost, and there is a difficulty in transportation of this energy or resources. Energy source is close to volcanic activity, and then that is dangerous. If there is some accident, then we need to stop the working of the power plant. As far as scenario in India is concerned, there are very few potential sites in India. Although India is one of the earliest countries to take initiative in geothermal power plant and the energy the electricity production through that, India has not installed any geothermal power plant which will be producing electricity. However, these potential sites can generate almost 10,600 megawatt of energy, but that is in direct use. So I will name these potential sites. One is Puga Valley in Jammu and Kashmir, then Tatapani in Chhattisgarh, Godavari Basin, Manikaran in Himachal Pradesh, then Parkeshwar in West Bengal, then Tuwa in Gujarat, then Unai in Maharashtra, and the last one is Jalgaon in Maharashtra. Thermax is one of the goods manufacturing company. It is in Pune. It has taken initiative and already in agreement with one of the Iceland based firm for installation of geothermal power plant. Student can visit this website for more details. Thank you for listening. I'll be with another video soon. Thank you very much.